If you love the ISUPK, stay in the loop. Go to Google Play and download the new user-friendly One West ISUPK app and get exclusive footage to our online classes and street speaking videos. Also, the Black Watch podcast, hosted by commanding General Yohanna, the leader of the Nation of Israel. It's real easy to stay in tune with the ISUPK and the information we're putting out. Just go to Google Play and type in One West UPK app and hit download. Let's get it in. Don't be left out.
DC has the highest rate of wealth inequality out of any city in the United States of America. You mean to tell me in the city that was once Chocolate City, in a city that was built on the blood, sweat, and tears of black people, we live in poverty while they live delicious? That's how America returns our sacrifice. That's how America returns our service and our love. Black people have never done anything to white people or to America for us to deserve this treatment. All we have ever done was serve America. That's all we've ever done. That's always been our problem. We always loved America, man. And because of that, we are destroyed. We are destroyed for loving America. Because God doesn't want us to love America. God hates America. You know why? Because America teaches our people to do everything against what he says. Everything that America tells you is okay, God says is wrong. They just passed legislation in Congress giving protections for the gay community. I'm gonna show you something right now. You cannot be a homosexual and be pro-black. You cannot be gay and be pro-black. I know it sounds crazy, but you're gonna have to choose. What you're gonna have to do is either you're gonna side with the gay movement and gay rights, or you're gonna side with your people and rights for your people. And the sad thing is, our people ignorantly march for them civil rights movement, and we reap none of the benefits, man. We marched and we got bit by dogs and sprayed by water hoses and got spit on, and our women got beat trying to go to school with these devils. And guess what? 50 years later, we still suffer the same thing our grandparents were suffering. And guess what? The white woman benefited from all our marching. All that we shall overcome, all that marching and protesting we did in the 60s, following them foolish pastors, we see none of the benefits. The gay community got rights before black people did, man.
Right.
Contrary to popular belief, you are not born gay, man, but you are born black. And I'll prove it to you. This is why God hates America. Give me Amos 9 and 8. God hates America, man. And if you are black, Hispanic, and Native American, if you had some sense, you would hate this place too. Somebody give me one reason why black people should love America. Give me one reason why blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans should love America. I want to hear it. I absolutely want to hear it, because we have no reason to love this place.
Right.
It does not have our best interests at heart to love America. If we had some sense of self-preservation, we would separate from America, man. Can't you see what they're doing to our people? Look what they're doing to our children. Look how they view us, man. Donald Trump got elected in office not because he was the most experienced politician, not because he was a war hero, not because he was a patriot. Donald Trump got elected because of his hate for you, black man. Donald Trump got elected because of his hate for our Hispanic and Native American brothers. And America put him in office because America sides with Donald Trump. And guess what you don't understand? Joe Biden is in office and he is Donald Trump too. He is Donald Trump. He's just more experienced, not to tell you to your face that he hates you. Every single president has hated black people. Every single president has done nothing for Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. And this is why God hates America. Read that.
The book of Amos, chapter 9, verse 8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord God are upon the simple king. Amos, chapter 9, verse 8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord are upon the simple king.
And you know what's crazy? Black people put Joe Biden in office. If it wasn't for black people, Joe Biden would not be in office. And what did Joe Biden do as soon as he got in office? Did he pass legislation to protect black people from these racist police officers? Did he pass legislation to get our Hispanic children out of cages? Did he pass legislation to give the Native Americans their land back? No, he didn't. You know who Joe Biden passed legislation for as soon as he got in? The gay community, man. Meanwhile, black people put Joe Biden in office. If it wasn't for black women going out and voting in mass numbers, Donald Trump would still be president. You understand? Say it again. He tricked black women with Kamala Harris, man. That's what they do, man. They always run game with our people. He didn't pass anything for black people. We still wondering if Breonna Taylor is going to get justice. We still trying to figure out if the murderer of Trayvon Martin is going to get justice, man. Get judgment. This is the life we live in this wicked kingdom called America. This is what the Bible says. Read it again.
Amos chapter 9 verse 8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord God are upon the sinful king.
The Bible says the eyes of God are upon the sinful kingdom, man. America lives deliciously on the earth. America is the most powerful empire on the face of the earth. And how did America get this powerful? Through righteousness, through ingenuity, through peace. America became the great nation it became off the blood, sweat, and tears of our forefathers, of the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, man. You understand? Like, we don't understand that America profits off of the destruction of our people. America profits off of black men killing each other. America profits off of us selling drugs to each other. America profits off of our women killing our babies in the Planned Parenthoods. America profits off of our destruction, man. And God sees it. While they live their lives deliciously, and we live in poverty and suffer in the ghettos, God sees it. And America think that God loves this place, man. I'm gonna tell you something, God does not love America. God is against America. And you're gonna find out more as time goes on. God says, the Bible says, his eyes are on the sinful kingdom, man. America promotes everything the Bible says not to do. How is it that your government passes laws to make it okay for you to be a gender that you're not? That is confusion, man. That is absolute confusion. And furthermore, it's a sin. It's a sin for a man to lie down with a man. It's a sin for a woman to lie down with a woman. The same way it's a sin for an adult to touch a child. You understand? The same way it's a sin to smoke the white man's weed and his cigarettes and sell that garbage to our own people, man. It's an absolute sin. And God sees it, man. God sees America and how America is destroying his people. That's a bad day for you, man. It's an absolute bad day for America when they realize they are destroying the chosen people of the Bible. I know it don't seem like it because we live in the ghettos and we live in poverty. But black man, Hispanic man, Native American, Indian man, you are the chosen people according to the Bible. Don't feel bad for that. Be proud of that, man. Because guess what? In just a second, that's what's going to save you from the destruction coming to America. But we got to come back to our culture. America's culture is sinful, man. Everything about America is deviant. You know why? Because America is Egypt and Rome and Greece all over again. America is a reincarnation of Egypt, of Greece, of Rome. And the Romans were notorious for molesting children, for being so evil to God's people. The Romans were the ones who murdered Christ. But we want to follow after America when America does not benefit black people, man. Read it again.
Amos chapter 9, verse 8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord God are upon the sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from the face of the earth.
God sees the wickedness of America, man. God sees how our oppressor lives deliciously in Washington, D.C., while our people live underneath bridges, while our people live on the streets and suffer in poverty, while black mothers have to figure out how they're going to feed their children, while black men have to figure out how they're going to get to that job that they have, where the boss is not paying them what they're worth. The Congress is fighting back and forth just to raise the goddamn minimum wage. That's how they feel about black people, man. They can't even raise the minimum wage. Meanwhile, the rich are getting richer. Jeff Bezos, the CEO of Amazon, is set to become the world's first trillionaire. That's what they do, man. They make all the money, and then they give us barely the crumbs. And then they get mad at us because we complain about having the crumbs, man. The people that we want to love and be a part of are absolutely ruthless, man. Absolutely evil. And if we had any sense, we would not do what they do, man. We shouldn't follow their culture. We shouldn't want to be American and join hands with them. The civil rights movement was a failure, man. The civil rights movement destroyed the black community. Those Christian pastors, in their ignorance and in their selfishness, told us to go and hold hands so that we can sit in a restaurant with the people that hate us, so that we can send our kids to school with those little devils, so that we can swim in the same goddamn pool as them, man. Why would you want to be around a people that hate you? It makes no sense. But we did it. We did it following those pastors that led the civil rights movement, man. And we did all that marching just for what? What do we have? We have absolutely nothing as black people, man. We have nothing because we chose to give it all to our enemies. Well, guess what? God sees this, man. God sees America getting richer and richer and richer while we get poorer and poorer. They had a damn mayor in Texas tell the people of his town, suck it up and stop complaining that your power is off. Go fend for yourselves. Like, this is the people that rule over us, man. They don't give a damn about us. While we want to go to the voting booths and participate in America's politics, it means nothing for us to do that, man. We have to come back to our culture found in the Bible. You understand? And our culture is this right here. The laws, statutes, and commandments. America has its constitution. And America's constitution governs its people. The problem is, that constitution doesn't give us the same equal rights and freedoms as the so-called white man, as the so-called Chinese man, as the Arabs and the Africans. That constitution of America says that black people are 3/5 human. But here's the good news, black man. We actually have a constitution of our own. We never knew that there's a black constitution where we have rights, where we have laws. And it's right here in the Bible. It's been in our face the whole time, and we never knew it. We never knew it because the Christian pastors have been lying. Have been lying in them churches. How long are we gonna sing and dance and think everything is gonna be okay? It's kids getting molested in them churches, and we still singing and dancing. Women getting raped in them churches. Grandmothers getting all their money stolen, man. All type of nastiness and perversion going on in them churches, and we still singing and dancing. When is the singing and dancing going to stop and we say, let's actually do some work now. Let's actually do the things that's necessary to build up our people. A white man didn't establish America by singing and dancing. No nation was ever established by singing and dancing and marching, man. Those people had to decide that we are going to come together with our people and we are going to do something to make sure that our people are protected. And this Bible is the protection for black people. The rules in here make sure that black people do not be destroyed the way we're destroyed. You understand? Read that.
Say me that I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob.
God is going to destroy America, but God is going to save his people. God's people are blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, man. I know it sounds racist and it sounds like hate speech, but this is what the Bible has always been saying. All throughout the Bible, it's talking to one specific set of people. The nation of Israel, the house of Israel, the lost sheep of Israel, man. We never knew that we were the Israelites. These are our forefathers and foremothers we're reading about in this book. This Bible is real black history. It's February, ain't it? Ain't it Black History Month? So why are we not talking about real black history, man? Why is it that black history seems like it starts in slavery? Whenever they bring up black history in America, it's slavery, the civil rights movement, Barack Obama, and then that's it. That's how it goes for us. When our history goes farther than that, man. Our history is so much more vast than what we've been doing in America, man. We were a people before we came here. And you can find those records in the Bible. And the Bible tells us what we can do to come back to be a people that are thriving, that are not just surviving in America, but actually living. You understand? Give me 1 John 3 and 4. The problem is because we don't know the Bible is our culture, we don't follow the Bible. And because we don't follow the Bible, we sin against God, man. Our people are sinning against the only person that can help us. We think voting is going to change our conditions. We've seen voting didn't do anything when we put Obama in office. Obama went and finessed black people all throughout Chicago. Jeremiah Wright was good friends with Barack Obama in that church. And that the black Christian church put Obama in office. And soon as he was running for president and he's getting close to getting in office, Barack Obama disassociated himself with black people and the Christian church. You know why? Because he used our people, man. He does what every politician does. Because Barack Obama is not a black man. Barack Obama is an African. And he understands he will never do anything for somebody that's not his people. You understand? And he shouldn't. Nobody should be forced to do anything for people that's not their people. You understand? We're not asking the white man to do anything for us. We're asking the white man to leave us alone to let us do for ourselves. That's what we're asking, man. But all throughout our history, he's always had to put his hand in our affairs. We want to come back and learn the Bible the way the Lord intended it, and he puts Christianity in our face. We want to come and follow our own culture and wrap our beards and our hair, and we go to a job and he says, we gotta shave that off. You gotta cut that off. We want our women to be feminine and to be wives and mothers again, and he pushes basketball wives in Love and Hip Hop Atlanta. We want our brothers to stand up and be strong and protect the family how we used to, and he pushes the gay agenda. Right, he signs the LGBTQ legislation. You see how they do? Sexual deviants have more protection than black people in America. There's no legislation to protect us from the police, man, from the cops. Where's the legislation in the bill to protect Breonna Taylor? Where was the legislation in the Congress passing laws to protect Trayvon Martin? Where was the legislation to protect Sandra Bland and Eric Garner, man? Who was all that legislation then? You see how America is showing us they don't give a damn about us, man.
Right.
They telling you time and time again. Gays got rights, man. It almost makes you discouraged if you're in the world. If you're a black man, you feel like the only way your life means something is you have to be a sexual deviant. You have to be gay in order for you to have rights. That's what America's telling you, man. This place is wicked, man. And the Bible says we have to stop sinning, man. That's what America is convincing our people to do, to sin. Because they know the only way they can destroy us is if we sin against our God. I'm going to show you what sin is, because your pastor is not going to tell you what sin is. You know what your pastor will tell you sin is? Not giving to his building fund, his the love offering for his wife to go get a vacation and him to buy his wife a Lamborghini truck. Right. Say it again, sir. Right, he tell you sin is being poor at the water. If you ain't got money, God is not blessing you. That's what the Christian pastor would tell you. That's why many black men don't go to them whorehouses called the church. Because we know that the pastor hates the poor. The black Christian church hates poor people. You know why? Because America hates poor people. And Christianity is nothing more than white supremacy, man. Christianity teaches black people to be great white supremacists while we're still slaves. You know how crazy that is? You fight for white supremacy and you a slave. You understand? We are still slaves. We suffering in America because we refuse to follow the Bible. Read that.
If you love the ISUPK, stay in the loop. Go to Google Play and download the new user-friendly One West ISUPK app and get exclusive footage to our online classes and street speaking videos. Also, the Black Watch podcast, hosted by Commanding General Yohanna, the leader of the Nation of Israel. It's real easy to stay in tune with the ISUPK and the information we're putting out. Just go to Google Play and type in One West UPK app and hit download. Let's get it in. Don't be left out.